Jen. It's good to see you again.
How you doing, all right?
Has anything happened since we were here last?
My son thought he saw someone in our bedroom. He said there was someone in there, but you never know.
On the tour, it was very clear that there were a few things that we thought we could debunk right away.
Yeah.
Now, typically, when someone just feels creepy in an area, we can go in with an EMF detector, find some device that's emitting a high electromagnetic field, repair it, and the ghost magically goes away.
Okay.
Such wasn't the case here. The whole house, EMF-wise, was just really low and totally within the norm. We even had Steve and Tango in your area really try to figure out what would make the pictures fall, and they stayed up there solidly. So we can't quite figure out what would naturally cause them to fall down.
So throughout the night, we started trying to see if we're able to catch any of this activity. We had to do the upstairs area of the home, and we really didn't find anything in there. So from there, we decided to head down into the basement area that's been converted to an apartment where your sister and her husband resides. Initially, when we got down there, we started getting hits to the K2 meter, responses to questions we'd ask, and we would get thuds that sounded like they were coming from up here in the kitchen. Again, in direct responses to questions we'd ask.
Do you know where it was coming from?
It was coming from directly above her bedroom, like from right here.
Pretty much here. I came up here to look at one point, and there was absolutely nobody in the home.
And at one point, I said, I'm going to count to five and then give a nice solid thump. And there was no thud. Okay, well, that pretty much shoots down the knocking action. And then the bedroom door to your sister's room slammed shut on its own.
I'm glad I didn't build down there.
Well, at one point, the fan started spinning on its own. Jay, the fan just started turning. I got up to check and see if someone had hit a switch or anything like that. Didn't happen.
While we were sitting down there, I was sitting on the couch.
Yep.
And Grant was sitting at the kitchen table downstairs. And he had actually pushed out the chair and told, you know, if you're here, hey, come take a seat with us. Let's talk.
Mm-hmm.
And there appeared to be some sort of an answer, and I'm going to let you hear it.
Heck, you can even have a seat. And tell me all your problems.
Here it comes.
Here, I'll actually highlight just that area.
Jay's talking in the background.
I can hear it. I can't make it out, though.
All right. Well, it actually sounds like a thank you to us.
You know
Yep.
I do hear it, thank you.
It definitely sounds like a male's voice. And again, direct answers to things that we are either doing or have said. It's pretty impressive. Now, there's one more piece that we'd like to show you.
There came a point where Jay was sitting on the couch and he was looking at the love seat over by the bedroom.
I saw what appeared to be almost like a flicker of a light, but as if somebody was trying to show themselves really quick, almost as if they were trying to, like, tune in to the right frequency to be able to show themselves.
Okay.
After I saw this, I stood up and I walked over to the couch in the back, and it wasn't there anymore. It wasn't present, but Grant turned the thermal imaging camera to that area, and here, I'll show you.
Okay.
Now you see, that's me, that's our cameraman, there's the couch. Now if you look, you've got a heat signature here, almost like a leg was coming down. You've also got one up here on the back of the couch.
I zoom in on it.
See it all?
Yep.
Right up.
Wow.
The only way that could happen naturally is if someone had sat in the chair maybe 20 minutes prior, because it's so much cooler than if someone had just gotten up.
Yeah.
But we were down there the whole time, and no one had been down there throughout the night.
So during that time that I had actually seen something flickering on the couch, we were able to catch a piece of audio, which we found very interesting, that I'd like you to listen to. Are you okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Jay's over there now, just trying to make sure that that knock was you. Yeah.
Now, did you just hear something there?
Yeah.
I'm gonna let you listen to it again. What it sounds like to us is, I will do this. Take another listen now.
Yeah, hear it.
Thinks you see something, it's a personal experience.
Mm-hmm.
And then we can back it up with the thermal that something weird happened in that corner of the couch. And just before that happened, we have a voice saying, I will do this.
Okay.
They all kind of validate each other and make it more of an interesting situation.
With everything that you guys caught here, do you think this place is haunted?
100%.